Good morning, students. Today, we shall do the poem Retired, written by Ian Crichton Smith. Now, when you hear this word retired, what do you mean by this? What do you understand by hearing this word retired? Here, retired means to leave your job and stop working. Usually because you have reached a certain age, like a person get retired from his job or from his working places when he or she reached the age of 60. When they complete the age of 60, they get retired and stay at home. So this poem is written by Ian Crichton Smith. Now, before explaining you the poem, let me just tell you about the poet. Ian Crichton Smith was a Scottish poet and novelist. He wrote both in English and Gaelic. He was born on 1st January 1928 in Glasgow, but moved to the Isle of Lewis at the age of 2, where he and his two brothers were brought up by their widowed mother in the small crofting town of Babel, which also produced Derek Thompson. He served in the National Service Army Education Corps, went to become a teacher, and he also taught in various places and later on got retired to become a full-time writer in 1977. Although he already had many novels and poems published. Crichton Smith's poetry quite often had a character, perhaps based on his mother. He also typically used natural images to convey emotion. His poetry includes Old Woman and The Man Who Cried Wolf. In 1980, he was made an officer of the Order of the British Empire. So that's all about the poet. Now let's come to the poem. This poem speaks about an astronaut who got retired after completing his voyages in space. And on one late evening, he looked at the moon through the trees and recollects his memories that once he used to be there in the space, and he feels nostalgic. Let us now read the poem. He was tired after his voyages, the shuttles from planet to planet, from star to star. In the late evening, he would sway in his rocking chair and watch the moon through the trees. I was there once, he thought. I stood on that globe. Now it is like a football shining in space. And he could hardly believe it that in his helmet and in his bulky space suit, he'd stirred that far dust. So, this is the short poem written by Ian Crichton Smith. Let's see what the first stanza tells us. He was tired after his voyages, the shuttles from planet to planet, from star to star. Now, here the word voyages means a long journey, especially by sea or in space. And the word shuttles means the voyages in spacecraft. It is a form of transport that travels regularly between two places, like as it is mentioned here, from planet to planet, from star to star. So in this first stanza, the poet tells us that he was tired. Now here, he means the astronaut, the one who is retired. So he is tired after having a long journey in space. So from this we come to know that he is an astronaut. And as an astronaut, he used to travel from planet to planet and from star to star. In the late evening, he would sway in his rocky chair and watch the moon through the trees. So here in the second stanza, we see that it is evening. And as he is tired, he sits on his rocking chair. Here, rocking chair means a rocker or a type of chair with two curved bands attached to the bottom of the legs, connecting the legs on each side to each other. So, he is sitting on his rocking chair and swaying. Swaying means to move slowly or rhythmically, backwards and forwards, or from side to side. So, this man is sitting on his rocking chair and swaying himself and enjoys the beautiful scene of the moon, which can be seen through the trees, through his window. I was there once, he thought. I stood on that globe. Now, it is like a football shining in space. In this third stanza, there is a simile used. Here, simile means a word or a phrase that compares something to something else. So, here he compares the moon with that of globe and football. Now, as he sits on his rocking chair, he recalls his memories that once he too was there in the space, standing on the moon or a globe, which is now shining as a football. And he could hardly believe it that in his helmet and in his bulky space suit, he'd stared that far dust. Here, the word helmet means a hard or padded protective hat, various types of which are worn by soldiers, police officers, motorcyclists, sports players, and others. And he, as a astronaut, he too wore the helmet that is worn by the astronauts when he used to be on his duty there in the space. Here the word bulky means taking up much space, large and heavy. The word stirred means moved or made the dust move slightly. So here, and in his bulky space suit, he stirred that far dust means the moon dust had been disturbed when he walked on it with his bulky space suit, that means his uniform, which was heavy and large. So, after recalling all these, he feels nostalgia. This poem is nostalgia. Here, nostalgia means a feeling of sadness mixed with pleasure and affection when you think of happy times in the past. So too, this astronaut who is a retired person now and is sitting and swaying on his rocky chair recollects the memories very fondly and feels nostalgic. So students, that's all for today's class, and I hope that you understood well. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the WhatsApp group.